Hi guys, welcome back to the channel. Today we're going to look at how you do exposure bracketing using the Nik HDR Efex and PhotoLab 7. Now, I've just been on a short trip to Costa del Luz and we found the most fantastic place called Los Caños de Meca. And there is a lighthouse, Faro Trafalgar, which has been very well photographed by lots of good photographers. And the challenge here was twofold. One was to get a frame that nobody else had taken. So I found myself sort of clambering about in the sand dunes. And the second thing was to shooting straight into the sun to get the sun star. So normally that would result in a silhouette, a blacked out lighthouse, but the challenge here and the way that we address that is to do exposure bracketing, and that involves five pictures taken one stop apart so you get well exposed parts of the picture that you can combine together and get one picture. Okay, let's get stuck in. So here we are in DxO PhotoLab, and I just want to take you through the choice of the pictures and why they were shot this way. So we'll look at the middle exposure. You'll notice here we're going from very dark, slightly dark, neutral, too bright, much too bright. Now the method behind this madness is that we want to get certain aspects of this shot from each of these pictures. So if we take the outer edges of these, we've got a lot of detail in this exposure, a lot of detail around this plant in the foreground, and that's really nice, really draws the eye. And the aim of this is to bring the eye from here through the middle of the picture and up to the lighthouse. So we've got very natural light here that takes us on a curved path. So the strategy here will be to extend effectively the remit of that curved path and bring the eye through with these objects. And of course we'll remove this wonky pylon over there. So if we go to the darkest of these exposures, you'll see that the sun star here is really nicely accentuated. So we want that sun star, but we also want the light on the lighthouse from the middle picture. And in so far as the middle picture is concerned, we want this to be brighter, this to be brighter. We want to move through this picture. It would also be good to have some detail in the sky, which we've got here. And of course, we'll be removing this person's head from the picture. And some of the distractions around the edges. Okay, let's send this to Nik HDR. So we select all of the pictures, we go into the photo library, and we hit Nik Collection, and we go to HDR Efex. We want to have a look at the sort of pre-processing settings here. So I leave alignment correction on. If it's shot on a tripod, there should not be any alignment issues, but there's no harm in leaving that on. Ghost reduction, actually I'm going to put ghost reduction on because I've noticed that there is, if we take that off, you'll see that there's a person's head there and that he's not in all of the shots. So we put on ghost reduction, and what that will do is effectively remove anything that's not in all of the shots. Chromatic aberration, we'll turn that on, but we'll leave it at the defaults. Okay, so that gives us our preview on the middle one, and let's go to create HDR. Now what this is going to do is to take the well-exposed elements of each photograph and combine them into a composite. And this is the neutral rendering of all five pictures blended together. And already you can see that this is perhaps a better version than the middle version. We've got rid of the ghosting there. We've got a little bit of an issue here around the outlining, but we're going to remove this in any case, so I'm not too bothered about that. And what I normally do is to look for a preset that is somewhere close to what I want to achieve with the picture. This one looks to be the best one, so we'll make this as our starting position. I'm going to take that down a little bit, so normal detail. See, this is accentuating our banding around that area in the sky, and that's not so good. So what we're going to do is we'll go take that back, leave that on deep, okay, and we'll just tweak the tonality in certain areas. Make it slightly warmer, but not much. That's nicer. Okay, and we're going to do the rest with control points. So we're going to add one here. And what this is going to do is to bring the processing to bear on the points we select. So I'm going to brighten this area up. Want some contrast in there. So what we're after really is the heads of this plant. A little bit of saturation. Make our blacks look a little bit blacker. And just warm it up a touch. Okay, and I think that's fine. And we're going to do the same thing, I think, with another control point. Okay, so we're just going to copy this control point. And we're going to move it to here. Okay, and I think that does the job. So we've got the same settings on that second control point. There's the first one, there's the second one. I think I like the way that that's looking now. You've got a clear pathway through the picture drawing us up to the lighthouse. Now, all that remains now is to apply that in PhotoLab 7, and let's have a look at that for some sort of finishing touches. Okay, quite like this. Right, well, first off, we're going to remove this pylon. So let's go here and we'll just remove it. And remove this, these lines. Okay, it's not made a bad job of that. Person is gone. I think the lighthouse is a little bit on the tilt, so I'm going to correct that. Turn on the crop tool. Yeah, ever so slightly, but not corrected that. And now let's just do a few finishing touches. So I think if we go back here, we want to have little bit more detail here. Now that's fine, our sun star looks good. We're getting this impression of evening light coming through. Do we want to warm this up a little bit? Let's have a look. There we go, slightly warmed up. I think that's better. Have a look at just if we touch these oranges. We don't want to get into the realms of fantasy here. So we'll just take that. I think it's good. We're getting some nice sort of yellows in the sky. I think what I might want to do actually is have a look at that vignetting in the top. All right, and let's have a look. Perhaps. So we're going into the minus, we're making that sky darker, but not much. We want to really tread a careful balance with that, and I think that's fine. Okay, right, there's obviously more that we can do with this picture, but this gets us, the point of this video was to explain the process that you go through to blend, exposure blend photographs using the Nik Collection and DxO PhotoLab. So effectively, we've stacked five pictures on top of one another. We've taken the well-exposed portions out of each photograph, and we're pretty happy with that. So that's how the basic corrections and the basic developing of this picture looks. And what I did was to obey my own rule, which is to walk away from the screen and come back and have another look. And when I came back, I thought to myself, this is too saturated, it's too yellow, and what I wanted to do was some more corrections. I also found, to my horror, when I looked closely at the picture, that there was a bunch of people in the sand dunes. So back to the drawing board, and the corrections that I carried out, I won't take you through the details of because they're all in other videos, but I used the correction tool in PhotoLab 7 to remove the people. I cleaned up the horizon a little bit using the same tool. I adjusted the vignette to make the corners of the sky a bit brighter. I desaturated the sand dunes and shed a little bit more light over the whole scene. So we're back to a more pastel kind of a color palette, and I think it's a much better photograph as a result of that. And here it is. Thanks for listening, guys. I hope this video made sense to you. If there's any questions you have, pop them in the questions down below, and I can answer those quickly. Otherwise, give us a tick for the video, subscribe to the channel if you're not already, that'd be really helpful, and we'll see you next week. Thanks.